Spiritual awakening refers to a shift in consciousness, a perception of reality which has been previously unrealized. The culmination of such realizations is in the recognition of oneness with all of existence.
Hey guys, it's Kevin. I am back again for another video. Today's video, we are going to talk about everything spirituality related, and most importantly, and more specifically, all about my spiritual awakening. Now, to be completely honest with you guys, this video is probably just as important to me as my coming out video. This whole process of spiritual awakening is a long, long time in the making. And I've gone through a lot of hardships and a lot of great things as well in order to come through the other side, a spiritually awakened person. So I hope you listen close. You might find some relief in this video yourself as well if you've gone through something similar and don't really know what to do about it. Also, throughout this whole entire video, I'm just going to be putting little pictures and snippets of videos throughout the whole video. They are all just related to my spirituality and times that I've been feeling a lot more spiritual than other times, just to give you a little vibe. I have an iced tea here with me. Iced tea. I have a cold brew coffee here with me, my new obsession, and we're just gonna get into it. So I'm gonna start off by talking about my background. Basically, I am 22 now. I am a gay male, as you may not have guessed already, and I grew up in the countryside of Ireland. One of my biggest hardships when growing up was dealing with being bullied, extremely badly bullied, dealing with being gay, all the struggles that come along with being gay on a daily basis. I struggled a lot with my first job, and then as well, another really big hardship for me was living alone. I don't really know the proper date as to when I became spiritually awoken, but I can probably pin it to about a year ago maybe. I'd come home from work nearly every single day, lie down on my sofa and just cry my eyes out. And I'd be lying there thinking, why am I crying? Like, what's going on? I had no reason to cry. Like, yeah, I was stressed at work and everything, but nothing more than the usual. I started feeling really depressed, and it was really horrible for me to feel, because growing up as a child, I always said that I would never get depressed. I always said that I would smile through my worries. I always said that stress was not a real feeling. All of that just because I didn't want to be unhappy. But it started getting really, really tough for me, feeling like I was just going crazy. Like, I didn't know that it was depression. I didn't know that it was a spiritual awakening that I was dealing with. I didn't know who to talk to. I didn't know what to do. I didn't want to turn to alcohol. I didn't want to turn to medication to make me feel better. And I think that this whole phase that I went through is known as the dark night of the soul. It's very common with people that are going through a spiritual awakening. It's like you have to go through all these hardships and be beaten down, beaten down, beaten down, get covered in mud in order to rise up again as a new formed person. So basically that is what happened with me. I discovered the whole world of crystals. I discovered the whole world of meditation. I discovered the world of spiritual guru. I discovered the world of spiritual guru. I can't say the word. I discovered the whole world of spiritual gurus online, and eventually, bit by bit, I started to see the light again. I was no longer feeling as dark as I was beforehand. I did go to therapy as well, and that obviously helped. But it was great as well, because the therapist that I went to, he kind of practiced a lot of spiritual things with me. And eventually I started breaking into the really good side of spirituality. I started feeling one with myself again. I started feeling like everything was in alignment. I was just doing things because it made sense to do these things. Like doing yoga, doing meditation, eating healthily, and doing the things that makes me happy. My spirituality is just like my depression, in the sense that it comes and goes, it has its days, it has its good days, bad days, and it's like waves of an ocean just coming and going. Some days it's stronger than the other, and some days it's not so strong. I don't go through every single day of my life feeling fresh and spiritually involved. And in a way, I feel like when I am very spiritually enlightened, that's when I'm coping for my depression. It's like my coping mechanism. the things that I do that make me feel great inside to my core is I will be involved with my crystals. I'll wear my crystals on days that I'm feeling down, like if I need extra energy around me. I will do my meditation. I focus and look out for synchronicities and different signs. I try my best to communicate with my spirit guides and listen to what they are trying to tell me. And I know a lot of people might think it's a placebo effect. But even if it is a placebo effect, I don't mind because it's what works for me, it's what makes me happier. For me, what my spirituality means to me is not so much putting everything that I have in something that's above me or out of this world. For me, mostly, it's actually about looking into myself, using my third eye, using my intuition and my initiative, and just really being true and one with myself. Instead of trying to focus on other people or other things or something higher than me and you, mostly it's about looking into myself. Oh my god, I can't believe I didn't even mention this. One massive thing that changed my life completely was when I started journaling. Now, this is a really big thing for people that are into spirituality. It's also a really big thing for people with any sort of issues or depression or anything like that. It's great for a lot of things. But I'm just going to read one of my journal entries for you guys right now, that is kind of related to feeling spiritually enlightened. So this is from the 11th of September, which is my birthday. I know. So, it's my birthday. Hashtag 22 Club. Feels kind of weird, to be honest. I'm feeling like I've never been so in touch with myself and the life I'm living. I used to always feel like I was never living in the moment, but now I feel extremely present. I feel a little too present sometimes. Alright, so I actually found another journal entry that I really liked as well, so I'm just going to read it out for you guys because there's actually a really, really inspiring quote in this one as well, so keep the ears open. So this was on Friday the 26th of October, 2018. Motivation is running through my veins, but my new lifestyle is more than just motivation. It's becoming my routine, and the longer I keep it up, the harder it will be for me to break it and go back to my old shitty ways. I read something powerful today from the book The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. Amazing book, by the way. He said, "Your problems are illusions. We have spent so long allowing our problems to define who we are and how we act. We use them as crutches, as excuses. For example, I'm too anxious to do this thing that I really want to do." That is you allowing your mind to take full control. Now guys, I think I'm gonna start wrapping this video up because, like, there is so much to be said and I still have so much more to say about this topic. I just want to finish by saying I think everybody goes through some sort of spiritual awakening or spiritual enlightenment, but maybe not everyone actually defines it as spirituality. Maybe they deal with it in a different way, or they've come across it in different ways, shapes, patterns, anything. But for me personally, this is what I class as my spiritual awakening. And you know, it's kind of like you fall into this dark hole, and then through going through that, you're much stronger and able to crawl back out of that hole, and you just see life in a different way. So yeah, I could talk about all of this for hours, but I'm not going to because you guys will probably want to shoot yourself. So thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed it, and I really hope that you can share some of your experiences as well with spirituality. I actually do have an ASMR channel, and a lot of the times I do talk about spirituality, so do check that out. Links in the description below. Thank you guys so much. Good vibes, positive energies, and yeah.